night action features the second meeting here in the College World Series between Wake Forest and your Fighting Tigers of LSU. Coleman's 0-2 pitch, swing and a miss, down on strikes. Coleman will take that as well. 3-2 pitch, swing and a miss, down on strikes goes Johnson. Griffin Herring with his second punch out in relief. Runners take their lead, first and second with two outs. The pitch, swing and a miss, strikeout number 5 for Griffin Herring. Guidry's 2-2 pitch, swing and a miss. Fired up as he should be, Cooper fires.
Oh, yes,
strike 3 at the letters, inner half of the plate. Tigers win, Tigers win. They're playing on Thursday here in Omaha. 2-0 to Beloso.
There you go.
Hammered in the air, down the line and right. Pierce Bennett That's going out. Back to the wall, and it's gone! Three-run bomb for Kane Beloso. Home run number 15. And the Tigers tie it up and take the lead here in the bottom of the third inning. First base. And Camden Manassi is ready to go. The right-hander facing the right-handed hitting Tommy White. Manassi leans in, now comes set. Rocks and fires. Tommy White lifts it high and deep to left field. Costello to the wall! It's out of here! Walk it off! Tommy White! Home run number 23! And LSU is moving on. Wake Forest is headed home. Tommy White down the third base line, gets showered and at home plate. 2-0. LSU here at the bottom of the 11th inning. Came to the plate with the best two hitters on the team, best two hitters in the country. Dylan Cruz with a base hit to left. Tommy White goes deep to left field. And LSU.
You guys got enough energy for two more? I'll be dead honest with you, okay? I want to win a national championship worse than I want to breathe, okay? But more importantly, hear me out right here. Hear me out. More than that, I just want to keep doing our deal, okay? Yeah. I have never been happier in my entire life. I'm not talking about hitting a walk-off bomb in Omaha. I'm talking about doing a deal with you.
Yeah! Yeah!
can be a lonely pursuit. It's the work you do when no one's watching.
Yeah, what'd you say? Dylan Crew's pretty good defender out there.
Yeah, he's a pretty good baseball player. Pretty good baseball player.
It's the commitment to continue when others are finished.
Score, the 1-2 pitch. Line drive, center field. Crew's on the run. Diving towards home plate. He makes the grab for out number three.
It's the willingness to suffer when others are stopped.
Ben, I've seen some long home runs, but that's got to be up there.
Dylan Crew is putting on a show here. But if you're willing to walk that long road long enough, at the end is a prize worth possessing.
The 0-1 to Crews. This one hammered to left center field. This time the park will not hold it.
Swings and unloads. Left center field. Grand slam, Dylan Crews.
The joy of your brothers, the adoration of the masses, and a legacy etched in gold. Welcome to the club, Dylan.
And an out away from a natty. Two outs, runner at first. The 0-2 pitch. Swing and a miss! And all is right in the world. Tigers win! Tigers win! The national championship is headed back to Baton Rouge. The dog pile begins left of the mound. A promise made and a promise kept by Tiger head coach Jay Johnson just over 2 years ago. Said, I'm here to get LSU to Omaha and back on top of the college baseball world. And after an 18-4 victory here tonight, tonight, it is the final game for the 2023 season, and the winner becomes legendary as national champions. Welcoming you one final time to Charles Schwab Field here in downtown Omaha, Nebraska. It all comes down to one game. In their eighth appearance here in Omaha, LSU will send out sophomore right-hander Thatcher Hurd. Looking for that first out here. The 1-2 pitch, swing. Cross at third, Joe Bear at first base. 2-0 Florida leads. No outs in the 0-2 pitch.
He's hit into left field. Jordan Thompson delivers. We go again. He hits it hard. That's in the hole. That's good. That brings in Pearson. Milosso puts the bricks on. White's got a 6 RBI. And the LSU Tigers lead it 5-2.
And the pitch. Breaking ball. Called strike three.
And then Langford. And this one is driven to left center field. Cruz is going back. He's still going back. Waits at the wall. The play. Oh, what a catch by Dylan Cruz at the wall. That's how you win a Golden Spikes Award.
1-2 pitch to Pearson in the air, high and deep to right field. This baby's gone. Josh Pearson, a rocket shot to the pitch to Kerwin. Breaking ball.
Called strike three. That'll do it.
Purnell's 1-1 pitch. This one
towards the right center field gap. Just the way it should be. Rolling all the way to the wall. Dylan Cruz around first. He's going to round second. The throw just to the cutoff man, and he will have a triple sliding in safely at third base. Dylan Cruz.
He is Steph Currying it to the ring finger right there.
1-1 rocket shot to right field. This baby is gone. Smash, the flip, and a two-run bomb. There it is. And for the first time since 2009 and seventh overall, the Tigers can say we are champions.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, good evening. Welcome to the home of the 2023 National Champions, Alec Box Stadium, Skip Bertman Field, the National Champs, your 2023 LSU Fighting Tigers. Thank you so much for joining us for this celebration tonight as we honor our 2023 national champions. We'd also like to thank Hancock Whitney for being our championship partner this evening. Got a lot of folks to introduce who have played an instrumental role in LSU reaching the pinnacle of college baseball. So we want you to direct your attention right now out to center field. We'll begin with our support staff and all the young men and women who have made this happen. We'll begin first with our strength and conditioning interns. Brady Hernandez. Ross Boyd. And Will Barker. Our athletic training interns, Amanda Reuthmeyer. And Trinity Salta Formaggio. Introducing our student managers, Caleb Westfall, Grant Pesha, Christopher Angel, Jacob Adams, Paul Loop, Austin LeBlanc, Manning Green, Patrick Harry, William Frankes, Jacob Calderera, John Griffin Stanford. Introducing more of our wonderful support staff, our nutritionist, Kayla Lawson. Our office manager, Virginia Robertson. Our academic advisor, Taylor Dennehy. Our undergraduate manager, Drew Finley. The manager of Alec Box Stadium and equipment manager, Matthew Montgomery. Our athletic trainer, Josh Walker. Our strength and conditioning coach, Derek Groomer. Our director of player development, video and scouting, Jamie Tutko. Our director of operations, Josh Simpson. And now the 2023 National Championship LSU coaching staff, assistant coach Mark Wanaka. Assistant coach and recruiting coordinator, Josh Jordan. Assistant coach and pitching coach, Wes Johnson. And now let's meet the members of the Tiger team, our national champion student athletes. Number one, pitcher, Gavin Guidry. Number five, infielder, Ben Napolt. A member of the College World Series All-Tournament team who set the College World Series record for strikeouts in a game, number nine, pitcher, Ty Floyd. Number 13, outfielder, Mick Paul. Number 14, pitcher, Nick Bronzini. Number 16, catcher, Brady Neal. Number 17, pitcher, Sam Dutton. Number 21, pitcher, Bryce Collins. Number 22, catcher and first baseman, Jared Jones. Number 23, outfielder, Josh Stevenson. Number 25, catcher, Hayden Travinsky. Number 27, pitcher, Jaden Newt. Number 28, outfielder, Paxton Kling. Number 29, pitcher, Micah Bucknum. Number 30, pitcher, Nate Ackenhausen. Number 32, pitcher, Aiden Moffitt. Number 33, outfielder, Ethan Fry. Number 34, pitcher, Chase Shores. Number 35, pitcher, Griffin Herring. Number 38, with three College World Series saves and one College World Series win, number 38, Riley Cooper. Number 39, outfielder, Zeb Ruddle. Number 41, pitcher, DJ Primo. Number 43, pitcher, Garrett Edwards. Number 44, pitcher, Blake Money. Number 45, pitcher, Caleb Appleby. Number 48, pitcher, Will Helmers. Number 49, pitcher, Javen Coleman. Number 50, pitcher, Grant Taylor. Number 53, infielder Jack Merrifield. Number 99, pitcher Christian Little. And now the players that were in the starting lineup for the final game of the College World Series Championship Series. Final score, LSU 18, Florida 4. National champions. Introducing first the starting and winning pitcher in the national championship game, number 26, Thatcher Hurd. Introducing next, the DH in the lineup on Monday night. From New Orleans, Louisiana, a member of the College World Series All-Tournament team, Cade Beloso. Starting at catcher on Monday night, he had a huge College World Series, offensively and defensively. Number 7, Alex Malazzo. Starting in left field, the sophomore with 2 home runs in Omaha, including in the national championship game, number 11, Josh Pearson. The Tigers starting shortstop for the past 3 seasons, 3 RBI in the national championship game, number 4, Jordan Thompson. Our starting right fielder, 3 home runs, 7 RBI in Omaha, number 6, Brayden DeJobert. The young man who wears the esteemed jersey number 8, starting at second base for the Tigers, 2 home runs, 4 RBI in Omaha, number 8, Gavin Dugas. A member of the College World Series All-Tournament team, the greatest first baseman in college baseball history, number 18, Trey Morgan. First team All-American, member of the College World Series All-Tournament team, 105 RBI on the year, number 47, Tommy White. One of the all-time greats in LSU baseball history. He's enjoyed an unbelievable 3-year career. All-tournament team in Omaha. Winner of the Golden Spikes Award. Number 3, Dylan Cruz. First team All-American, winner of the Dick Houser Award, 209 strikeouts, an all-time SEC record. The most outstanding player of the College World Series, number 20, Paul Skeens. Just today, this gentleman was honored by Collegiate Baseball Magazine as the National Coach of the Year, Head Coach Jay Johnson. Coach Jay Johnson, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, is the first coach in NCAA history to lead his school to a national championship within the first 2 years at his institution. An amazing accomplishment for Coach Jay. Your 2023 national champions, the LSU Fighting Tigers. All right, we've got a lot of celebrating left to do, and we're going to start by introducing a number of very special guests that are here with us tonight to honor our national champions. First, help me welcome the governor of the state of Louisiana, the Honorable John Bel Edwards.
Good evening, Tiger fans. I want to thank you all for making this the best venue in college baseball anywhere in the country, not just because of the facility, but because of the fans. What you bring each and every night, not just in Baton Rouge, but what you brought to Omaha. So thank you. Coach, players, congratulations. The seventh national championship for LSU baseball. Congratulations and thank you. The people of Louisiana love the LSU Fighting Tigers. And they love those Jell-O shots too. 68,888. So congratulations to you. Go Tigers and God bless.
Thank you so much, Governor Edwards. So throughout this evening, we're going to bring up a few players and have them speak to you guys, maybe answer a couple of questions about their careers and about the experience in Omaha that led to a national championship. First player I'd like to bring up to the podium is our first baseman, number 18, Trey Morgan, native of New Orleans, Louisiana. Trey, just going to ask you a couple of questions. And first of all, anything you'd like to say to the crowd first, go ahead.
Man, I just want to first and foremost thank you all for the best 3 years of my life. This was awesome. I wouldn't have rather do it anywhere else. No, thank y'all. And it's an honor to put LSU back on top.
So, Trey, I think we're going to have it up on the board here, but your defensive play against Wake Forest, one of the greatest plays defensively in College World Series history.
Skeens, 0-1, looking to bunt down the first baseline. Morgan will get it. Up to get it to Milazzo. Tag applied. He's out at home. Trey Morgan sprinting down the first baseline. Gloved it. An option pitch to Milazzo standing at the plate, and Johnson is out.
What a play right there by Trey Morgan.
All right. Trey, give us your thoughts, your perspective on how that play unfolded.
I mean, the play unfolded just like it does in practice. The hundreds of thousands of times we did it right here until we got it right. It looked just like that.
So you've enjoyed a remarkable career here, native of New Orleans, worked tremendously hard from the time you were a small child with your mom and dad giving you all that support. Talk about what that support meant to you and how it got you to where you are now.
Yeah, I mean, my family is definitely my biggest supporters. Without them, I wouldn't be here. This would all be a dream. Growing up in New Orleans, you look at LSU play on TV, whatever sport it is, and you want to emulate them. You want to follow in their footsteps, and I got the chance to do it. It was an honor. It's awesome.
Trey, thank you so much for everything, and congratulations. You are a true national champion.
Yes, thank you all. Thank you.
All right, please help me welcome now to the podium our next very special guest, the Mayor President of East Baton Rouge Parish, the Honorable Sharon Weston Broom.
How about this? LSU, 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 go Tigers! How many Tiger fans do we have out there tonight? How many baseball fans do we have out there tonight? Well, Coach, we want to invite you to come up. We want to celebrate you tonight and our wonderful baseball team. We are Baton Rouge proud of our LSU Tigers, of the baseball team, and we want to present you on behalf of the city of Baton Rouge, the council, our office, the key to the city. These baseball Tigers and you have definitely won the key to our hearts. Go Tigers.
Thank you so much, Mayor Broom, and thank you so much for being with us here this evening to celebrate this very special occasion. All right, time to bring up another player. How about a young man who hit 24 home runs on the year, including one very special one that lifted the Tigers into the College World Series Finals? Let's take a look. Bottom of the 11th inning versus Wake Forest on Thursday night.
Florida leading 3-2. Pitch to White. In the air to left field. Going back is Shelnut to the track, to the wall. It's out of here. Tommy White ties the game with one swing of the bat. And the Tigers now 3, Florida 3.
That was another of Tommy's home runs. That one came in the National Championship Series. But of course, Tommy, you did hit that walk-off home run against Wake Forest. What a game that was. No score going into the bottom of the 11th inning. Your teammate Dylan Cruz leads off the inning with a base hit. Wake Forest brings in a relief pitcher. First pitch that you see from him, sails into the seats of Charles Schwab Field, lifts the Tigers into the National Championship Series. Your thoughts on how it unfolded?
Yeah, I was just looking to drive a pitch and up. I knew how to get the ball up. I didn't want to get into a double play. I was actually sitting fastball, got a slider, but I was just too amped up, and I had to swing. Got the bat head out in front, and it got in the air.
So, of course, this is your first year at LSU.
Yeah.
And it won't be your last. Tommy's back for 2024, by the way, fans. Just your thoughts on this experience, Tommy. When you first arrived here last summer, the expectations that you had and how this experience maybe has exceeded what you expected.
Yeah, and more. Being LSU Tigers, everything. This is my home now, and I love it. Every single one of you guys. It's been awesome.
Tommy, thanks so much. Congratulations. Tommy White. So fans, as you know, LSU is governed by a board of supervisors which oversees Louisiana's flagship university and its many campuses around the state. At this time, please join me in welcoming the chairman of the LSU Board of Supervisors, Valencia Sarpy Jones.
What an incredible evening to be in Alex Box Stadium. Good evening, Tiger Nation. It is my great honor and privilege to be here this evening to celebrate the powerhouse of college baseball, the LSU 2023 NCAA Baseball National Champions. I am thrilled to celebrate your extraordinary accomplishment as you continue to build upon the foundation for greatness that was established during Coach Skip Bertman's era, that continued with Coach Paul Maneri, and now with Coach Jay Johnson. Thank you to our talented and accomplished baseball players, Coach Jay Johnson, and the entire coaching and support staff for such an exhilarating season. You started the season as number one in the country, and you finished the season as number one in the country. You were the clear champions from day one. Not only did Tiger fans tune in, but the nation watched as you won the Men's College World Series, the most watched game in its history. You have contributed to the legacy of dominance and distinction in baseball and the LSU brand. Thank you, Governor John Bel Edwards, members of the Louisiana Legislature, my fellow members of the LSU Board of Supervisors, Mayor President Sharon Western Broom, our faculty, staff, students, Bayou Bengals, and students everywhere for supporting, celebrating our student athletes. On behalf of the LSU Board of Supervisors, congratulations, champions.
Thank you, Board of Supervisors Chairman Valencia Sarpy Jones, and we greatly appreciate the support of our Board of Supervisors. All right, time now to bring up another player. Let's bring up a fifth-year senior who has 2 degrees from LSU. Comes to us from New Orleans, Louisiana, Cade Beloso. All right, Cade, now I believe we have your home run in game one of the championship series against Florida. Again, a very dramatic, thrilling game. Top of the 11th inning, scores tied. Cade Beloso at the plate. Let's take a look.
Here's the 0-1 to Beloso. Hit high and deep to right field. Giving it a look is Shycoffer, and this baby's gone! Cade Beloso gives the Tigers a 4-3 lead. second home run of the College World Series for the LSU graduate who rounds third. 4-3 LSU.
What a great moment, Cade. That home run gave the Tigers the lead, and LSU closed it out in the bottom of the 11th to win game one of the championship series. Cade, just your thoughts on that at-bat and what it meant to you and your club.
Yeah, I mean, he just blew a 0-1 fastball right by me, and it was a terrible pitch and a terrible swing, so I kind of knew he was coming back with that again, and you know, finally got a good one to put a good swing on, and it happened, and just was so thankful that, you know, we won that game and won the national championship. So,
Cade, I think everyone here knows how hard you've worked to be in this position. You had a great freshman season in 2019. Of course, we had the COVID season of 2020. 2021 didn't go the way you wanted, but you came back with Coach Jay and worked very hard, worked yourself into the starting lineup for 2022, and in that awful injury right before the season started. You could have ended your career after last year. You decided to come back. Just tell us your thoughts on what it meant to you to return here to play for these great fans and for your teammates and to reach the pinnacle of college baseball.
Yeah, I mean, it means the world to me. You know, thank you so much for, you know, welcoming me with open arms for the past 5 years. And I love you guys so much. And yeah. Yeah, and I just want to, you know, I love Coach Jay so much. And, you know, he wasn't going to let me end a career like that. And, you know, so thankful. And I'm forever indebted to Coach Jay and, you know, teammates in the LSU. Sorry.
Cade Bledsoe, folks. Thanks, Cade. Thank you. Now it's my pleasure to welcome to the stage the president of the Louisiana State University System, Dr. William F. Tate IV.
Coach Johnson, every player, every coach, athletic department staff, I want to give them a heartfelt congratulations. And I don't know if you're like me when you come to the Alex box, you might want to listen to what the players are listening to when they walk up to the box. Always pay attention to it. I have a couple I'm going to share with you. I know it's hot, but these guys deserve this. The first one I always hear is this Calabri 2008. It resounds through the stadium. It's like an anthem, a fierce determination. That song didn't win a Grammy, but the guy that played that song won the Golden Spikes Award, and that's Dylan Cruz. You know, sometimes we don't talk about freshmen. We have number 13 from Utah, Mr. Paul. I listened to his song a couple times. You Know How We Do It. It resonated in the air. It represents the swagger in this team, the confidence they have. Who in the world loses game two of a series by 20 and turns around and takes the natty by 14? This is not a football game, folks. This is what you call swag. You have to know what you're doing, and you have to be fearless with an attitude. You know, I could go on with the songs, but I want to say something to each one of you. First of all, personally, I'm going to say this from the heart. I have never been in an athletic event in my life where an athlete comes up the bat who is struggling and the fans give him a standing ovation and call his name out. I have never seen that before in my life. You're the best. LSU family, the players aren't the only ones with walk-up songs. Every time we come to this box, every single game, we start with the national anthem. Every game. Governor Edwards, I know you're a man of the United States Military Academy, the Army, but the group that originally adopted what we call our national anthem was the United States Navy. Yes. They did it in 1889. And in this box, every time I walked up to hear that walk-up song, that most important song that we sing, you all do something that's a little bit different than the Navy had it planned out. The words are like, over the land, or over the land of the free, and the home of the... It's most appropriate that y'all change that song up, because LSU is the shipyard of college sports. LSU Athletics is aiming to be and have more ships than any naval yard in the world. And I gotta say this. We already had a little bit of Navy flowing. I'm sorry, Governor. We're crewing on the SSS Dillon. We're covered by a tank named Tommy. We're supported with air cover by Skeens. We defended our first position with the Morgan, and up the middle is guarded by Thompson, Dugas, Travinsky. Our outer perimeter is patrolled by Joe Bear and Pearson. Beloso, that's a stealth. Folks, all hands on deck. Best pitching staff in the country. I know we shortened the Star Spangled Banner, but I have to say this to you. We only do the first verse. The fourth verse includes this, and this is our motto, "In God We Trust." I say this as your president. I pray every day for this university. I pray for this team and trusted that no player would experience a life-altering injury and that LSU baseball would play their very best. Prayer answered, thankful, go Tigers.
Thank you so much, President Tate. Also joining us tonight, a gentleman we'd like to recognize with us is the Lieutenant Governor of Louisiana, Billy Nungesser, here with us this evening. Thank you, Lieutenant Governor Nungesser, for joining us as well. Now time to bring up another fifth-year player also who has earned two LSU degrees during his fantastic playing tenure. He's played just about every position on the field except pitcher and catcher during his LSU career. From Houma, Louisiana, Gavin Dugas. So, Gavin produced the very first run of many runs scored by the Tigers in Omaha when he hit the home run against Tennessee in the opener. And he also homered in game one of the National Championship Series against Florida. Let's take a look.
The 2-1 in the air, down the line, in left, giving chase. And this ball is into the bullpen. Gavin Dugas with his second home run here in Omaha. And the Tigers lead 2-0. Hey, now.
Gavin, you guys had such a remarkable offensive season. Just 1 through 9, there was such balance and power throughout the lineup. Just your thoughts on what it was like to be in a lineup with the guys of that caliber.
At the end of the day, it's just awesome to be able to be a part of a team like this. And when you see 1 through 9 every day as a pitcher, an opponent, I get really nervous. And I always get nervous for our opponents just because of the caliber of talent that we have. Not only 1 through 9, but on the bench. Guys that get up and get ready to play like that just shows you how good and how well coached we are. So it just gives a credit to the coaching staff and the ability level of the players.
So Gavin, in 2021, as you know, fans led the SEC in RBI. In 2022, had to battle through a lot of injury, but still by the end of the season, was making major contributions to the Tigers at the NCAA Regional. This year, hard to believe, he wasn't even in the starting lineup when the season began, but worked his way back to a position of prominence.
Tigers starting second baseman, one of the leaders of the club. Gavin, wearing that number 8 jersey now for 2 years. Just tell us what it has meant to you to be a part of that program and to be in that leadership position.
There's no greater university than LSU. We're the best. Coming to this place, being from home in Louisiana, it's always been a dream come true. And being able to wear a number 8 is just an honor that I dreamed about every night. You know it, and you guys make it so special. My teammates, my coaches, being here for 5 years, it's been home. So at the end of the day, it's just such a great position, and I'm really thankful from the Lord just to be able to be here today and talk to you guys, and it's just awesome. I love you guys.
Thank you so much, Gavin. Congratulations. All right, fans, it's time now to hear from the gentleman who, as I told you earlier, was named the Collegiate Baseball National Coach of the Year. In just 2 seasons, he's led the Tigers to the promised land, the championship at Omaha, College World Series champions. Please welcome our coach, Jay Johnson.
So I didn't do a lot of preparing for this speech today because I was working on 2024 season, so bear with me. I did want to peel back the curtain and talk about this team a little bit because this was a special journey. On January 14th, we had a meeting, which was the day before we could start practice or training, as we call it, this spring, and we came up with just a thought process. And we titled it The Road to the Top. And I'll be honest, this is the very first team that I've coached from day one that I believe could win a national championship. And on that day, on January 14th, I just asked a very simple question, like, what do you want to do? What do you want to accomplish? And it was very clear and very serious, Coach, we're going to win a national championship. And so I start with that because it's very easy to know you have a good team or a talented team. It's an entirely different thing to commit to it every single day and then follow that road step by step to the top. And as I said on Monday night, it was more gratifying because we didn't just win the national championship on Monday night. These guys were national championship people and players every day of the 2023 season. So in that meeting, once we decided that that's what we wanted to do, we broke it down very simply. What did we need to do that? We wanted to play a brand of baseball that you, our fans, the best fans in college baseball, this university, the entire state, could be incredibly proud of. So right now, I want you to give these guys a hand because that's exactly what they did. So, what did they do? They played with great fundamentals. We had the best offense in college baseball. We led the country in on-base percentage, slugging percentage, runs, and I don't know if there's ever been a team that's more exciting to watch with the style that they played offense. It was a pitching staff that struck out 798 guys over the entire season. They competed, and what does competing mean? To us, it meant simply this. I wanted them to value winning more than anybody else that sat in that dugout across from us. And I think if you saw this team on a night-in, a night-out basis, nobody valued winning more than the 2023 Tigers, and that was demonstrated every pitch of every inning of the entire game. It led to 54 wins. Lastly, we talked about character, you know, having the ability to make the right decisions both on and off the field and represent you in a way that you deserve to be represented. We talked about being a no-drama program, and you didn't hear one thing about one player for an entire school year doing anything other than something positive for this university. The physical talent, borderline unmatched. We talked about wanting to dominate the mental game. What did that mean, staying in the moment? So much so, like, I didn't really realize we were going to win the national championship till one out in the ninth inning the other night because we were all so locked in on staying in the moment. Recovering from failure, I think they lost two games in a row two times all year. And when you think about the schedule that we played, that's borderline remarkable. They resisted the urge to be complacent. And I don't think you ever saw them take a night off in terms of doing what they needed to do to win. They played to a standard above winning. They were the most selfless group of players in America, which I wanted to highlight. Hayden Chervinsky, stand up for a second. I'm pretty sure this guy had a pretty good NCAA regional here. I'm pretty sure he had a pretty good super regional, and he did not start a game through the first 25 games of the season. And not one time, and we all saw his talent, did he ever question, why am I not playing? He just kept working, getting better, improving, and when it was his time, boy, was it his time. Alex Milazzo, where you at? Milazzo, yeah. The guy's got a broken leg and he's standing up right now. Give him a hand. I'm not sure there's a better defensive catcher in the country, but we have a lot of catching talent when you look at Brady Neal, Alex, and Hayden, and it all contributed to this national championship. But again, wasn't playing every day right from the start, but never wavered. Caught a phenomenal College World Series once Hayden and Brady were both hurt. And how about this guy's offense? He was on base his first three at-bats of the national championship game the other night, hit over 290. So I bring that up because being selfless was a big part of this deal. And how do we define selfless with this team? We didn't have to look too far, because you have two of the greatest coaches in college baseball history right here with Skip Bertman and Paul Maneri. And all we wanted to do, yeah, go ahead. You know, how we defined being selfless was the way they got their players to be selfless. And their stories of Kurt Ainsworth redshirting and then becoming a pitcher on one of Coach Bertman's great teams. Mikey Matuk and Austin Nola didn't start at the beginning of their freshman year on the 2009 national championship team. So we took some of those examples all throughout the program on the teams that hung the flags, that had numbers up on the intimidator, and said if they could do it, we absolutely can do it, and that's what it's going to take to win a national championship. So again, give this team a hand for being the most selfless team in America. So it's really hot out here, so I'll finish with this. We in the SEC tournament in Hoover, Alabama, we lost 2-5-4 games in the SEC tournament. Didn't feel like we were playing our best baseball. Had a team meeting. They had a team meeting as well. And we just talked about two things. For the next 4 weeks, make sure you have the right head, the right heart. We're 5 wins away from the College World Series. We're 10 from a national championship, even though it actually took 11, and they absolutely did it. So give these guys one more hand as the national champions in 2023. Last thing before I turn it back over to Bill Francis, who's the best SID in the country for any sport, is State of Louisiana, LSU, you have my entire heart. There's nowhere else in the world that I want to coach baseball than right here, right now. I love you guys.
Coach Jay Johnson. So at this time, we'd like to announce the recipients of some very special awards. In fact, the most prestigious awards in college baseball. Coach Johnson will make these presentations to the players. So at first, we will announce the winner of the Dick Houser Trophy. Now, the Dick Houser Trophy is named in honor of Dick Houser, who was a player and coach at Florida State, then went on to a great career as a manager, in fact, led the Kansas City Royals to the 1985 World Series title. Then just 2 years later, he tragically died of cancer. Well, his daughters created a foundation in his name and a means by which to honor the best NCAA Division I player each year, honored with the Dick Houser Trophy. Now, prior to this year, LSU had one winner of the Dick Houser Trophy. You all remember Eddie Furness in 1998. Eddie's number 36 is one of the retired jerseys here at the box. Eddie won it in 1998, but it had been 25 years since an LSU player had won the Dick Houser Trophy until this year. The winner of the 2023 Dick Houser Trophy, America's ace, the best pitcher in the country, Paul Skenes. So the Dick Houser Trophy, by the way, is on its way. It'll be to Paul very soon, so he'll have it in his possession. Another trophy, which he picked up, of course, just the other night, most outstanding player of the 2023 College World Series. Congratulations to Paul for that very prestigious honor as well. Paul, of course, you had two very productive years at the Air Force Academy, actually pitched on this field against LSU as a member of the U.S. Air Force Falcons team. Last summer, you made the decision that you wanted to have the opportunity to play professional baseball. In order to do so, you'd have to leave the Air Force Academy, which I know is a very difficult decision. You, of course, had many schools who wanted you to come and play for them. LSU was your choice. Tell us why.
Yeah, obviously the brotherhood at Air Force is very difficult to walk away from, but I'm glad I got it here and got to experience it with these boys. And I mean, you guys are a big reason why I came here. The fans and playing here at Alex Box every weekend was way too good to pass up, and so glad that I came here.
Paul, of course, we know about your incredible numbers on the field and the impact you made for this team throughout the year. Maybe what fans don't see is the way you impacted your teammates. I know throughout the year, your teammates, whenever they were asked about you, spoke about your presence in the locker room and what it meant. Tell us what you thought was most important for you to bring to this team.
I think coming here to lead and you know, kind of build the brotherhood among other people. Obviously, when I come here, I'm going to have a brotherhood with each guy on the team individually, but building that with other people and building the love in the locker room among everybody else that was in there, you know, to have the camaraderie and experience everything together as a team led to a lot of fun moments.
Fans, you may also be aware of Paul's very philanthropic side. He pledged an amount of money for each strikeout that he fired this year, and there were 209 of them. He pledged funds for each strikeout to Folds of Honor. Paul, tell us about Folds of Honor and what it means.
Yeah, obviously coming from the military, it means a lot to me, the sacrifice that everybody in the military makes. I had two teammates who died one of them died while I was at the Air Force Academy, and one of them died before I got there while they were in service. Their families have partnered with Folds of Honor, you know, to help their families and others get scholarships to get education. And so I wanted to do something to give back to the community that offered so much to me. And Folds of Honor was an opportunity for me to do that. And I'm glad we had a lot of strikeouts, and I'm glad we had all of you guys donate as much as you guys did. It means a lot to a lot of people.
And finally, Paul, I don't think any scene depicted the camaraderie and the spirit of the LSU baseball program better than after the final out was recorded on Monday night, and Alex Milazzo, who had suffered a broken leg early in the game, hopped on your back, and you carried him to the dog pile. Tell us what that meant to you.
Yeah, it meant everything. Alex caught me all year, and there's a special bond between the pitcher and the catcher, and I was next to him in the dugout, and I told him I wasn't going out there if he wasn't coming out there with me. So we found a way to do that, and I'm glad he got to experience it.
Paul Skeens, thank you so much for everything you've contributed to our program, to our university, and to our state. We greatly appreciate it. Now, this has never happened before in the history of college baseball, where one school produced both the Dick Houser Trophy winner and the Golden Spikes Award winner. Now, the Golden Spikes Award, regarded as the Heisman Trophy of college baseball, it also had been won just once by an LSU player. And that guy's in the house with us tonight, the 1989 winner, Ben McDonald. Ben, of course, led LSU to Omaha on two occasions, went on to a great Major League Baseball career, and now a very prominent announcer with ESPN. So it had been since 1989 since LSU had a Golden Spikes Award winner until this young man came along here 3 years ago. In 2021, made a tremendous impact, was the National Freshman of the Year, 2022 First-Team All-American, SEC Player of the Year, 2023, again, First-Team All-American, the first player in SEC history to win SEC Player of the Year in back-to-back seasons. And to cap it all off, just before the second game of the championship series, he was announced as the winner of the 2023 Golden Spikes Award, All-American Dylan Cruz. All right, Dylan, I'll let you go ahead and I thought you wanted to say a few words first, so I'll let you go ahead and speak to the fans.
Man, that thing's heavy. No, I just want to say none of this is possible without you guys, these coaches here. I mean, I can't put words to it. This is unbelievable. Thank you guys for the support for these past 3 years, best 3 years of my life. I mean, these guys behind me have built some of the best relationships with them. We're national champions, baby. What else can I say?
So, Dylan, in the spring of 2020, you're a senior in high school in Longwood, Florida. You've already attracted, of course, the attention of all the Major League Baseball clubs. You could have easily been selected very high in the 2020 draft and started your professional career, but you elected instead to come here to LSU. Tell us about that decision and how it's benefited you.
Yeah, it was a tough decision. You know, I was an 18-year-old kid, not really sure what to do with my life. And, you know, every single day, LSU was on my mind. You know, it felt like it was something that I couldn't miss out on. And, you know, it was a week before the draft, I decided I'm going to take myself out and I'm going to go to school here and experience this with my teammates and, you know, get ready for the next level. And best decision of my life, for sure.
I know Coach Johnson all year really emphasized how important your leadership was to the club. And I think that leadership was no more evident than last Monday, the Tigers suffered an agonizing loss to Wake Forest. And you guys know you've got to win 3 games in 3 days to advance to the National Championship Series. You have to go through Tennessee, and then you have to go through the team ranked number one at the time, Wake Forest. Just your thoughts on the way the club came together and approached what appeared to be a very daunting task, approached it with confidence and succeeded.
Yeah, I mean, it felt like, you know, that wasn't a task that we couldn't handle for sure. You know, we've been dealing with that all year, and, you know, it just goes back to our motto since day one, just one pitch at a time. And controlling the strike zone, and we do that, good things will happen. And I wouldn't have rather to have another team do that than these guys right here and go to war with them every single day. So it was awesome.
Then, of course, finally it culminates with the College World Series Championship Series. You guys get a thrilling win against Florida in Game 1. Game 2 is a rough day for LSU. And you know, a lot of folks were probably questioning whether or not the Tigers could rebound. But I remember your statement in the press conference after the game. You said, and this is maybe about 15 minutes after the game was over, you said, I think everyone in our locker room has already forgotten about it. We've moved on. And that's exactly what happened. Just talk about the way you guys did move on and really dominated that final game.
Yeah, I'm not going to lie. We got punched in the mouth a little bit that game. Yeah, we forgot about it right after the game. Right after it ended, I think that's what makes this team special is that we're able to, you know, turn the page and move on to the next day. And, you know, we got our minds right, got our bodies right for the next day, and, you know, put on a show. We knew that it was our last game together, so, you know, nobody in the country was beating us that day.
And finally, Dylan, I know you said on many occasions one of the reasons why you came to LSU was because you wanted to find a second home, a place you could call home besides your home's area in Central Florida. Just talk about what home means to you when you think of Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
It means everything to me. I mean, from what I was expecting as a young kid, it just completely tops that. I mean, I'm just so thankful right now, man. I can't put words to it, but now that it's, you know, all over, you know, I'm so happy. Thank you guys for your support. You guys have made this very special to me, and I'm happy to call this my second home.
The 2023 Golden Spikes Award winner, Dylan Cruz. So at this time, I'd like now to welcome LSU Athletics Director Scott Woodward. And he's become accustomed to doing this kind of thing lately. And I'd like to have Coach Johnson join Scott up here at the podium. And as Scott presents Coach Jay with the National Championship Trophy, also want you to take a look at what's going to be unveiled behind us. Your national champions, the 2023 Fighting Tigers. Thank you, Louisiana, for your support of Fighting Tiger Baseball. When you come to the box for 2024, you'll see a brand new Intimidator with all seven national championships represented. And guess what? You can start requesting season tickets right now. Go to lsutix.net for the 2024 season. Thank you for celebrating with us. Thank you for your support all season long. Baseball at the box. There's nowhere better on earth. We'll see you next season. Go Tigers!